In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use asdf to install Ruby and get a Ruby on Rails app up and going. Let's jump into installing Ruby on Rails the 2020 way. Before I start, I just want to highlight this tutorial is for Linux and Mac OS. If you're on Windows, I suggest you go use Docker. I think there'll be a tutorial coming out about that soon. The other thing is sometimes advice changes over time and these videos are hard to update. So if you are searching for like help, just be wary about people who suggest using sudo on Stack Overflow. The other thing I want to mention is there are other ways of installing Ruby, including rbenv, truruby, and rvm. We're going to be using asdf because it supports multiple languages. So let's get started with asdf. So if you click get started on their website, they have a really good page to kind of give you all the instructions you need for your machine. So if you're on Mac, you'll probably pick Homebrew, install the dependencies, then install asdf, and then lastly, you'll probably add it to your shell. And adding it to your shell means you can run the asdf method, which is very, very important. So I've installed asdf. If I run it, I now get all these options I can run, which is very handy. So what we're going to do is we're going to run asdf plugin list all. And this is going to list all the plugins we can install. So asdf works by you saying which languages you want to be able to install. So for example, I could install R, V, I could install Ruby, I can install Elixir, I can install all those things through one tool, which is really good. So we're going to install Ruby. We're going to add Ruby. Okay, it's added Ruby. We don't get too much feedback, but it's been done. So the next thing we're going to do is install the latest version of Ruby. So install Ruby latest. And it's going to download and install this version of Ruby onto the machine. Once it's completed installing, there's one last step you need to do to make sure you use the correct version of Ruby, like kind of everywhere. And it's to do asdf global ruby and type the word 2.7.2. So this is the version up here. This means whenever you run Ruby, it'll run that version as opposed to falling back to the system version. One of the other gotchas you need to be aware of is a lot of Ruby projects use the .ruby version file to specify which version of Ruby they want you to use. ASDF has a different approach where they have a tools version file, I think, to kind of make sure things are compatible. If you open up your asdfrc file, if you add the line legacy version file equals yes, it will then look for the .ruby version file and it will just save you a lifetime of headaches. Because Rails uses Webpacker and its prerequisites include Node.js and Yarn, we need to install those. So we're going to do asdf plugin add Node.js and asdf plugin add Yarn. So that's going to give us access to go and install these plugins. And now we just need to install them. So if we do asdf, install Node.js latest, and asdf, install Yarn latest. Now that we've installed Node and Yarn, we need to also set them as globals. However, it's a bit hard to decipher which version we've just installed from that. However, if we do asdf list, we can see which versions we have installed. So I can see I've got 14.4.0 and 1.22.10. So we're going to do asdf global node.js that, and we're going to do the same thing here for yarn. And that means if we do yarn.v, it will just always load that version, which is very helpful. We're now going to actually install the Rails gem and create a new app. The first thing we're going to do is just double check where Ruby is coming from and where the gem executable is coming from. They should be in an asdf folder. If they're not, let's run asdf reshim ruby and 2.7.2. This will just repoint all the executables to be in the right folder. So now I'm going to install Rails by just running gem install Rails. And so if we were to do which Rails, you can see that's coming from the SDF shim, which is very cool. And if we were to now create a new app, we could do Rails new. We have a lot of options we can pass into it. I'm going to just generate a really bland one in the current directory by just passing a dot to it. That may take a moment to run, but just let it run through and you should be all good. Once it's kind of installed and you've got all these files here, you can run Rails S, and this will turn on your local Rails server. And okay, so let's grab that URL and we're going to open that in a new window. There we go, we've installed Rails and we can now start making apps, which is quite cool. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am MikeRogers0 on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching and I will catch you next time.